Good evening, Detroit. I'd like to thank you for joining us on the first edition of With My Own Eyes Only. We are a production company here in the city specializing in awareness and community action. This evening, we're privileged to be in the home of Jeff Neal, our guest. I'd like to introduce Jeff right now. Good evening, Jeff, and thank you so much for allowing us to come in and talk to you about some of the issues involved with being a Black Club president here in the city of Detroit, and also being a lifetime resident. By the way, Jeff is also a tradesman. He's a pipe fitter. And so we're going to talk to him a little bit about some of the things that are going on regarding diversity in skilled trades in the city of Detroit. Jeff, I'm very, very, very pleased to be here. You know, it's not, you know, it's a lot of times people, you know, trying to get them to talk and get an understanding of how they feel. You're dealing with a lot of things. You're crossing the line. You are a Black Club president. You are a tradesman, a pipe fitter, and also a resident of the city of Detroit.
Correct.
One of the things that we'd like to talk to you about today is, I want to start off with being a Black Club president. What do you find to be your most fondest or your most rewarding item as far as being the Black Club president of the Wildermere?
I would have to say my biggest reward is just getting everybody to come together and do things as a Black Club, not as individuals.
Okay. Being a resident of the city of Detroit, what are some of your most fondest memories of growing up, of participating and being a part and seeing the different Black clubs across the city?
Just going to different Black club parties. They had a lot of activities for different Black clubs in this neighborhood. We had a lot of kids. There was a lot of kids in this neighborhood when I grew up. And we all stayed together, we hung out together, played together, spent the night at each other's house, and everybody knew everybody. Everybody knew each other's parents, and parents knew if you did something wrong or you did something right, they knew who your parents were, and they just looked out for it. Everybody looked out for everybody else.
You know, that's a very unique situation. Something like that, you have to have an attitude where you want to be a part of something. Do you find that now people are more or less staying away from each other, or are people still willing to reach out to each other and involve each other in each other's lives?
I think everybody wants to, but I don't think they know how, and I think everybody needs a push to get going in the right direction of togetherness. I think everybody looks at it as they're on their own, but they're not. It's a community, it's a neighborhood. I say I always look at it as a neighborhood, as a family, really. I mean, because that's what we were when I was growing up. Everybody was, we were all brothers in this neighborhood, brothers and sisters, but now everybody tends to try to be to their self, and I like it the old way.
So what you're saying is you see yourself as a motivator. You're able to have people come outside of their parameter and actually try to involve different people, different families in what they're doing, and also participate in their neighbors' activities and things like that.
Yeah, yes, I feel like, you know, I'm just trying to do my part to help everybody else maybe benefit from anything I can. I just want to help any way I can.
I'd like you to hold that thought, Jeff. We're going to take a break here, and we're going to come back, and we're going to talk to you a little bit about your profession of pipe fitting. Okay?
Yes, sir.